running for the thrill of it, thrill of it. Always pushing up the hill, searching for the thrill of it. All and all and all, we are calling out now to get. Never looking down, I'm just an oral, what's in front of me.
Hey Goddard Lions, it's your Goddard Friday. We're your host, I'm Isaac Klein.
And I'm Zachary Burton. See our previous shows, you can view them on YouTube by searching Goddard_media.
Don't forget to subscribe. To kick off our show, here's Jordan Pennington with a Goddard Sports Recap.
Prepping for regionals, fall sports is working hard to finish out the season. Here's the recap. Up first is girls golf. Varsity Golf competed at the AVCTL tournament on October 4th, placing 4th overall. Sydney Chapman tied for 10th with a score of 96, Allie Hamlin placed 16th with a score of 100, and Jade Simeona placed 17th with a score of 104. Golf regionals took place on October 10th, where they tied for 8th as a team. Senior Allie Hamlin says that the girls have a good chance at making it to state.
It's a little nerve-wracking, but I think we can get to go to state as a team this year if we all shoot pretty well.
Wish your varsity golf good luck as they head to state on October 17th and 18th. Next up is volleyball. The girls lost both matches 2-0 to Valley Center and Cheney on September 29th. On October 4th, they rallied and were defeated by the Andover Central Jaguars and the Arc City Bulldogs 2-0 both. Senior night was held on October 11th, and the girls fought hard against Andover and Andover Central, losing 2-0 both. Volleyball's next game is on October 15th at home. Come show your support. Boys soccer has had a busy but rewarding schedule. They won 2-1 against the Eisenhower Tigers on September 29th. On October 3rd, they defeated Winfield 6-1, and the following day, the Lions beat Valley Center 6-2. At home versus Andover on October 6th, the boys lost 3-4, but came back on the 11th and defeated Mays 5-4 in overtime. They play El Dorado away on October 13th. Following is cross country. The team competed at Halstead on September 29th, where 6 out of the 19 runners ran PRs and the team brought back 8 medals. Varsity boys took 5th overall, and the varsity girls improved at their Wichita tournament on the 8th, where Emma Deck ran a PR and will advance to state. 5 out of the 6 boys varsity runners also PR'd on the 8th, and overall, Goddard placed 9th. The next cross-country meet is the AVCTL Championship on October 15th. Varsity girls tennis played at home on September 27th and took 2nd place. Their league match took place on October 3rd at Eisenhower, where they placed 4th overall. Leah Combs finished 6th place in singles, and Alyssa Rising finished 7th in singles. Girls tennis regionals were on October 8th, where Alyssa Rising and Regan Lefebvre lost in the 3rd round to Capen, and Leah Combs also lost in the 3rd round to Eisenhower. Finally is football, where they showed great determination against Andover Central, winning 20-14 on September 30th. At home on October 7th, they defeated Mays South 33-14. Devin Mathis led in rushing yards with 176, and Tanner Steven led in tackles with 7. Senior Carter Klein says what this win means for the Goddard Lions.
Coming into the game, we were 0-6 against Mays South, but coming out with this win, it feels pretty well. It feels pretty good. That win will probably determine our playoff.
The boys finished their regular season today, October 14th, against Salina Central at home. This has been your Fall Sports Update. Reporting for GHS Media, I'm Jordan Pennington.
Make sure to support your Goddard Lions. Let's see what's happening at GHS with our weekly Roar segment. Starting with our recap of the fall play, here's Vaughn Nguyen.
The Goddard Theater Department put on their production of Fools by Neil Simon on September 29th and 30th, as well as Sunday, October 2nd. Stage manager Kelsey Warner tells us about her job and what her favorite part of the show was.
My name is Kelsey Warner and I'm a junior this year. It's my third year doing theater. My job for this show was the stage manager. I wrote down all the stage directions, led warm-ups each day. I learned light and sound and much more. My favorite part of the show was probably just seeing the show come to life and showing how each character and each actor brought something unique and hilarious to the show.
The theater department always puts on an amazing show. Make sure to look out for their next big performance. Signing off from Goddard Media, this is Vaughn Nguyen.
That was a great play. National Honor Society is a prestigious group of students who show scholarship, leadership, service, and character. To show us who got in, here's Taya Peppard.
On Wednesday, October 12th, the National Honor Society held their annual induction ceremony. They inducted 39 new juniors and 4 seniors. Candidates were selected based on GPA. They then submitted a letter of petition, resume, and 2 letters of recommendation. They are then reviewed by character, scholarship, leadership, and service. Reporting for GHS Media, I'm Taya Peppard.
Congrats to everyone who got in. Next up, Ethan Pape shows us what's happening at Mass Band Night.
At the last football game, the middle school joined the high school to perform an amazing performance. Let's see how it went. The Goddard Band always puts on an amazing show, and I cannot wait to see what the middle school does next year.
Our band is amazing. The food drive is right around the corner, and here to give us more information is Briley Sagerty.
The food drive is happening October 16th and lasts until October 21st. It's a great way to get students involved to donate food for people in need. It is also a great way to earn star points. You can donate any non-perishable item. For example, you can donate peanut butter and canned and boxed foods. Our goal this year for the school is to gain 10,000 star points for items. At the end of the food drive, there's a surprise incentive. Make sure to bring items or cash. Reporting for Goddard Media, I'm Briley Sagerty.
Make sure to donate. Want to see how the class ranks in star points? Well, here's Sienna Summers with the update.
Wanting to get more involved in school? Star points gives you that opportunity. Right now, seniors are in the lead with 920 points, and second place is freshmen with 893 points. Third place is juniors with 877 points. Finally, in fourth place is sophomores with 844 points. Reporting for Goddard Media, I'm Sienna Summers.
Don't miss out on a chance to get star points. Now, time for a Goddard Friday Classic. Here's Caitlin Johnson and Emma Culver with Lion and Tail.
Hey Lions, what is up? We are here at the Goddard football game against May South, where we are currently winning. It is halftime. We're here to ask you guys some questions in the student section. Who is your favorite player?
Tyson Wallace, number 32.
Tyson Wallace, 32!
Tyson Wallace, baby! I got it!
Give us your student section fit check.
All right, so we got jean shorts, 51 degrees, don't care! We got this shirt. We got dinner vest. We got this hat that's made for dogs, but we don't care!
Are you a freshman?
I'm a senior!
She's a middle schooler.
Student section cheer.
Bula Bula.
Yes. We'll win this game.
Yes.
Thank you.
What is your favorite cheer?
No, I can't say that. Hey, Lions go. Big blue.
Thanks to everyone who participated. And for our final segment, here's Caleb Squeska and Taryn Edwards with the second episode of Goddard Gems.
Hey guys, welcome to the second episode of Goddard Gems. Today, we're doing JoJo's Coffeehouse.
Let's throw it over to Yonah to see how it all started.
I'm CJ Wilhelm, and I'm the owner of JoJo's. I actually went to Goddard High School, and so I've been in the community for a while, and there was never anything like this growing up, like where we could just like come and hang out and study. And so I just wanted to kind of open that up for like students and people in the community to just come and hang out and actually have a place to like go and just mingle with each other, talk, or come and study. So right now is our fall, so I would say our pumpkin spice has been a really big hit because we hand make it in-house, the pumpkin spice syrup, so it's totally different than what you're gonna get at like a Starbucks or a bigger chain because it doesn't come in a bottle, we hand make it. But if you're not looking in the fall, I would say the Lion Iced is gonna be a big hit.
JoJo's offers a large variety for whatever you're in the mood for. There's coffee, tea, and really yummy bakery items.
It is the perfect place to hang out with friends or a comfortable study space. And that's a wrap for the second episode of Goddard Gems.
Grab a friend and pop in the JoJo's for some quality time and some great coffee. Signing out for GHS Media, I'm Taryn Edwards.
And I'm Caleb Sweska.
I can't wait to grab a coffee and hang out with friends.
Well, we hope you enjoyed the show.
Have an amazing day, Lions.